was very, very upset how someone can do that to such an innocent animal. It just breaks my heart.
A North Fort Myers woman is out of jail tonight, accused of forcing her dog to eat rocks to survive. That dog was found on Pioneer Road, underweight, infested with fleas, and left to fend for itself outside.
This area is surrounded by farmland north of Bayshore Road, west of State Road 31. The dog's owner, Carmela Santiago, now faces several criminal charges. NBC2's Jennifer Veglis is there tonight with how deputies learned about this dog.
Deputies say it all started with a tip from a neighbor. When they arrived, they found Blanca the dog severely emaciated, covered in fleas, yelping for help.
I'd want to puke.
That's Bobby Winslade's reaction today, learning her neighbor, 37-year-old Carmela Santiago, left her dog Blanca surviving in these conditions.
My reaction would be, why'd you get a pet in the first place?
Sheriff Carmine Marcino and the county's Animal Cruelty Task Force couldn't agree more.
Zero water. It was baking literally alive in the sun.
Today, breaking down how it all happened. Friday, one of Santiago's neighbors contacted them. When deputies arrived, they found Blanca panting, tethered to a tree so tightly on Pioneer Road, she couldn't access her bucket of food or this flea-infested bowl of water.
Veterinarians confirmed Blanca had a severe flea infestation, causing her to be anemic. She had a temperature of over 103 degrees and was positive for heartworm.
Blanca was so hungry, she ate rocks to feel full. Blanca's condition, heartbreaking to say the least, her spine protruding. I showed photos of her to Adrian Cruz.
Oh my God. Yeah, I think she deserves his jail time, for sure.
His mom, Robin McCullough, says she wished she knew about this sooner.
Tell her to her tree and do the same thing to her and see how she likes it.
The big question, of course, is how Blanca the dog is doing today. Sheriff Carmine Marcino says she's currently receiving care, but has a long road to recovery. I'm in North Fort Myers, Jennifer Veglis, NBC2.